Hello, everybody. I'm Rob Howe, the rockstar realtor with Elite Realty. I'm the realtor, but you are the rockstar. And today, I want to talk to you about the real-time changes that are happening right now during the holidays, whether you're a seller or a buyer. You want to know what I'm talking about? See you on the other side. All right, everybody. I came over here to the parking lot at Wet n Wild. That's right, because it's a fabulous day, and while I wouldn't want to be swimming or going into a water park, because it is, still cold enough that would really not be fun, I wanted to show you around a little bit over here. I have a listing over in Summerlin South, and I had to come by for the inspections. So today on this video, I want to talk to you about, for you as a seller or a buyer, what the differences are during the holiday season. Basically, the end of the year, where we are now, it is December. Why this is significant and why it'll matter to you, I'm going to tell you. So I just had a client, on a buyer side, for the first time in well over a year. Initially, as soon as the contract went into play, I got them closing costs paid by the seller. It's been a long time because this market's been so hot that you really couldn't get that. As a matter of fact, you had to offer everything. I mean, you had to give them the firstborn child. So now I've finally got a contract that we were able to get not only a price reduction because, well, they were overpriced, but also some seller paid closing costs. It's still a little rare because if a property is listed and priced right, there's probably not a lot of room in that seller's mind or the competition that you're going to have with other buyers to be able to add closing costs in. Where I have been able to get some closing costs paid was later on in the negotiation period after we did our inspections. If the seller was really happy with the initial offer and didn't want to have to, break that offer and move on and find another one, well, they'd negotiate with you still. In a contract situation, when you're buying a house, you have a couple of different points where you're gonna negotiate. In some cases, during this last year, even during the inspection period, people just had to tell the seller that they were taking the home basically the way it is. We don't like to use as is, but they were gonna take the home as is and they were not going to request any repairs. So obviously I told you I have a buyer that got seller paid closing costs. And they got a significant chunk. I almost forgot to mention a couple of important details about closing costs, seller paid closing costs, that you should know as a buyer. If you're using a conventional loan, depending on loan to value, down payment, you can have up to 3 to 9% seller paid closing costs for primary residence. So that's quite a bit you can have in there, 3 to 9%. Of the total sales price for closing costs from the seller paid closing costs. For second homes as well, obviously your lender's gonna wanna let you know what range you're in. For investment homes, only 2%. You can only get up to 2% closing costs paid for an investment home. Good to know if you're an investor, right? Also for VA, it's 4%. Up to 4% seller paid closing costs. VA does have some unallowable costs. Anyway, I won't get into that, but if you want to know more about that, you know who to ask. FHA loans up to 6% for seller paid closing costs. So now I will return you to your regularly scheduled programming of me driving around and telling you more about buying and selling during the holidays. Here's what happens, and I tell people this all the time. You have these dips. And this tells me that, as I've been saying in many of my videos, especially my Robnostications, that we are coming into more traditional times. The historic, crazy, unprecedented stuff that's been happening is starting to evaporate a little bit in the market, and we're getting back to a traditional type of thing. We're still very robust considering the relatively low inventory, but this tells me that we are in this better place, if you will, for a buyer, because when a holiday like Thanksgiving comes around, the buyers sort of tail off a little bit. You get less competition out there. It's this lull in the market period where if you can remain active and continue to look for property and put your offers in during that time, that's when you might be looking to get a deal. That might be a moment where you can ask for a little bit more from a seller because you have less competition out there. Now you have to be able to judge this and make that correct judgment, but depending on the area, depending on the hotness of that area, you know, the buyer activity, and this is where having faith in your realtor is very important because you gotta be able to look to them and say, hey, what's really happening here? That agent should want to get you that home, of course. So they want to give you the best advice possible in order to attain your goals. But right now, when you look at Thanksgiving or the Christmas holidays or, you know, that these times of years, buyers kind of like, you know, they fall asleep a little bit. You know, they get a little sleepy on the tryptophan and they don't get too active until a little bit after Thanksgiving and into December, and then they'll slow down once again right around Christmas time. So this could be a very good opportunity for you. Now, as a seller, there is still opportunity for you too. It's just, I think you want to have certain aspects understood. You may need to be a little bit more patient because you're gonna think, okay, well, it's been hot market, but then suddenly you get a little less activity because you're of the time you're listing. But if your home is one of those homes that's like gonna be rare regardless of the time of year, well, it will be a hot commodity for people. I just proved it in one of the listings that I had up here in Summerlin South. Hot property could, you know, basically one of one in the area for quite a ways and sold, you know, by the weekend. We listed it, I think, Thursday, sold by the weekend, you know, full asking price. Plus some other nice little perks that were put into the contract. So from the seller's perspective, you have to have certain elements that make sense for you to want to put your property on the market at this time of year. Certainly not terrible because this is still a strong market, and I can prove that with what I've been able to do on the sales that I've had. So another note to the buyers, a lot of times the sellers don't want to put their property on the market right now. So the question is, if you don't get involved now as a buyer, what's going to happen into spring and as we get into next year? Are we going to have more inventory and not enough buyers for it and then the market changes? Or are we going to have plenty of buyers and still pretty scarce on inventory? I'm actually thinking that's where we're headed right now. There's a number of things in play that I'm keeping a tight eye on that I want to see how it what happens as we turn into next year. Right now, I think I'm predicting another strong year for Vegas. Nothing like we had last year as far as historic, unprecedented activity. I would be absolutely shocked if we had that kind of thing happen again. It just would not make sense. I just think there's already too many buyers that have been pushed out of the ability to purchase. Although they're constantly under pressure with the rent prices. So if you aren't purchasing, you're renting. And my goodness, if the rental market isn't still bananas and nuts and just, I mean, I'm gonna tell you something that I can assure you I've never seen at any point in Vegas, which is the level in which we have risen and how quickly the rental market has changed, because landlords are asking for much higher qualifications and they're asking for a whole lot more money in rent and they're just being incredibly stringent on what they want. It's really kind of horrific, to be totally honest. I'm going to use the word horrific. You have unprecedented levels for qualifications and the rise in rent prices. It really caused a lot of pressure on people, created a lot of pressure. Now the other side to that is that the buying market has become so much more appealing because, well, it's clear as day that purchasing a property is a lot more affordable than renting a property. And my goodness, it's a lot easier. It's actually easier. I would have a harder time finding some people a rental in certain situations by a lot, and it's really just been this way throughout my career, than I could finding them a home to purchase. So if you can get pre-qualified and purchase a home and you're renting right now, you need to do that. There is absolutely no reason why you shouldn't. You're thinking, oh, well, the prices are going to be too high and they're going to come down. Well, I don't know that I can tell you that's going to happen. I don't know anybody that can tell you that's going to happen. But what I can tell you is that you'll lock yourself into a price that is affordable versus renting. And one thing that I don't think is happening is the rental market is going to take some big nosedive and suddenly cost you a lot less. So you're talking years of paying high rent prices versus purchasing your property and locking in your price on what you pay monthly and owning that thing so that you can't be told you're going to move when the landlord decides to sell the property. I know that there are many people in a situation where they can't do that, and this is where I think the rental market has gotten horrific. So that's why I'm using that word, horrific, because I do think it is horrible what's happening there. Hey, there's Red Rock. So I've come all the way from Summerlin South. I'm over here going down Charleston. I'm gonna go back home here. So from my perspective, this time of year, around late November, and even early January, if you're looking to be a buyer, you need to be active right now to find your deal. Because I don't know that anybody in their right mind that can tell you that we're gonna turn this corner on next year and suddenly things get a whole lot brighter for you as a buyer. I think they stay similar. I think there's possibilities of interest rate changing, going up. So this is a really crucial zone, in my opinion, for a buyer to go out and purchase. And as I tell you that, sellers, listen up, because there are still people who are gonna wanna buy your home and pay you top dollar for it. So I just wanna say, finally, happy holidays, everybody. I hope you enjoy the beautiful weather that we're having in Vegas, if you're watching from Vegas. Speaking of historic, we just had a historically warm November. In all of my life, I've never had such a beautiful November. I'll take it. And so far, December has been ridiculously, just absolutely gorgeous. I'm sure as we turn the page on the year, we'll get our winter weather here. Yeah, we do get winter weather. Sometimes it's pretty cold, windy, you know, especially when you're used to acclimated to the warmer weather here. And then that wind comes a whipping, you know, it gets a little impolite. I know all you East Coasters and even some that might be listening in areas like Canada or watching in areas like Canada, I know you guys are just like, you know. But again, it's all of what you're acclimated to. The cold feels colder when you have 110 degree weather and then you switch over to a wintertime weather. All right, thank you for watching, and remember to subscribe to my channel. If you're looking for a realtor, now you know how. You need somebody on your side. You need somebody that knows the lay of the land. And I know Las Vegas like the back of my hand. So give me a call, 702-461-7175. Go to my website, robhowrockstarrealtor.com. Hit me up on an email or throw a rock through my window with a note tied around it. When you need me, I am there for you. Everybody have a great day. Thanks for watching.